Hello students, today we'll cover another very interesting chapter from your class 11 syllabus, Discovering Tut, written by A.R. Williams. This is a very interesting chapter about, I suppose if you are interested in history and all, you'll definitely like it. Now, written by A.R. Williams, this chapter, Discovering Tut, is about the last heir of the powerful Pharaoh dynasty. Now, what is a Pharaoh? Like we called in Hindi, Raja. In English, king. Similarly, in Egypt, the king was called as a pharaoh. So he was the last heir. Heir means vansha, the person who had been continuing with that particular dynasty. Tutankhamun, who died when he was a teenager after ruling for 9 years. So basically, he became a king at a very young age and he died when he was a teenager. And even after ruling after 9 years, he died in a mysterious way and is peacefully resting in his tomb now. This chapter throws a light over all the possible mysteries, the pharaoh's curse, his treasure, his life, and untimely death. Egyptians believed that there is life after death, and that is the reason they buried the pharaohs with wealth and everyday use items. And what was the pharaoh's curse? Pharaoh's curse was a curse they used to imbibe on that particular tomb while burying it, that death or misery would befall on any person who opens this tomb. So this was the curse they used to put. Tutankhamun, also known as King Tut, was a teenager when he died. He was the last successor of his powerful Pharaoh dynasty, which ruled Egypt for centuries. He was laid to rest, heavily loaded with gold. His tomb was discovered in 1922 by Howard Carter, which made the world raise a question about what had happened to him and whether he had been murdered. After almost 80 years, his body was about to undergo a CT scan, which would give new information and clues about his life and death. His face would be recreated with the help of a procedure called forensic reconstruction. Now, let me give you a brief reason why Howard Carter discovered King Tut. Now, at that point of time, people used to love digging. They used to believe that there used to be a lot of treasure inside the graves, especially of the graves of the monarchs. So Howard Carter one day saw a faience cup, a cup, and on each the stamp of King Tut was there. Then again he saw a lot of jewelry in which King Tut's stamp was there. So he decided to find the tomb of King Tut, hoping to find a lot of gold in it. So, a strange atmosphere prevailed as King Tut's body was taken from his grave called Valleys of the Kings. Dark clouds moved quickly across the desert all day long and later they covered the stars. On January 5, 2005 at 6 p.m. King Tut's mummy, which is the world's most famous mummy, was placed in the CT scanner to investigate the mystery behind the death, which had occurred more than 3,300 years ago. So, although his tomb was discovered in 1922, in 2005, people decided to do a CT scan to this body. So, this was the first mummy which was CT scanned ever by the archaeologists. So, that is why it is very famous. And this was the richest treasure which has ever been found in the history. So, that is why King Tut is very important. All afternoon, tourists visited the 26 feet deep underground rock-cut tomb to pay respect to the king. They looked in admiration at the murals. Murals are large paintings on the walls of the chamber and took a look at the face of Tut that had been painted with gold. While visitors read the guidebooks in a hushed tone, some stood silently, wondering about his untimely death in his teen years. They might also be wondering if the pharaoh's curse, that death or misfortune would befall upon the person who disturbs him, is true or not. As Zahi Hawass, the Secretary General of Egypt, leaned over his body to have a look, he said that the mummy was in very bad condition because of what the British archaeologist Howard Carter did it in 1920s. Now, Zahi Hawass was a person who was responsible to get this CT scan done. So, at that point of time, the mummy was in very bad shape. I will tell you the reason why. Because Howard had discovered King Tut's tomb in 1922 after a long search. The valuable treasures of Tut had been explored earlier too, but surprisingly, they were complete. The treasure found at Tut's grave is richest till date. It had beautiful artifacts in gold that was also varied with daily use things like a razor made of bronze, board games, linen undergarments, and boxes of food and wine which he could use in the next life. So Egyptians believed in life after death. So they had buried even a razor for him, that he might be needing a razor later on. He might be needing undergarments. He might be needing wanted to play. So board games like chess, etc. were also buried along. Now this is the treasure, this is the actual treasure of King Tut which was found. So you can see a lot of necklaces, all made in gold. So everything was found when his tomb was finally opened. Carter took a few months to record the treasure found in Tut's grave. Then he began investigating his three coffins which were nested one in another. Now this is the picture of Howard Carter, the first archaeologist who discovered his tomb. In the first coffin, he found a red colored shroud. Now, what is a shroud? So, kehte hai kafan, Hindi mein kafan or English mein. Now, you understand what is a shroud. With garlands of willow, olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and cornflower, which suggested that he had been buried in the months of March or April. Now, what happens is, like somebody dies in anybody's house, so you see that you tend to sprinkle a lot of rose petals, flowers on it. So, similarly, garlands of willow, olive leaves, celery, lotus, the cornflower there. Now, cornflower was generally found in March or April. So, people thought that definitely he must have died in the month of March or April. When he reached the third coffin, he was in trouble. The body had hardened due to the resin which had cemented the body and it had stuck to the bottom of the coffin which was made of gold. Tata wondered what to do next because no amount of force could separate the body. Now, Egyptians, what they did was, before putting the body into the coffin, they used to put a spread of resin. You know what is resin? Resin is a kind of a liquid. Just say gum banti hai, gum, glue. So they used to spread a bed of resin aur uske upar body rakhte the. So obviously it has been so many years, so the body had actually stuck to the bottom of the coffin. So Howard had to take out the treasure, so he wondered what to do. So Carter tried to loosen the resin by keeping the body in the hot sun. He kept the mummy in 149 degree Fahrenheit heat for several hours, but still it remained stuck. He decided to use a chisel to cut down the mummy from the limbs and the trunk so that the Tut's body could be taken out of the coffin. So Carter ne kya kiya, usko dhoop mein rakh diya bahut der tak. Egypt waise hi hai, waise hi sun mein, itne dekha shayad melt ho jayegi, but nothing happened. It did not melt at all. It was still stuck. So he had to cut the body at various places in order to take out the gold. According to Carter, he had no choice other than to cut the mummy. He believed that if he hadn't done that, thieves would have removed the gold from the tomb and would have looted it. So it's better that it goes into the government's treasure. During Tut's time, the royal people were very wealthy and they had a belief that after death, they could take the wealth along with them for his life after death. He was given precious collars, necklaces, decorative patterns, bracelet, ring, amulet. Amulet kya hota hai? जो हाथों में पहनते हैं ना चूड़ा काइंड फिंगर्स में वंस द ब्राइड इज देयर वाइल गेटिंग मैरिड तो वो पहने हुए थे उसने सेरेमोनियल एप्रन सैंडल्स शीट्स फॉर फिंगर्स एंड टोज इट वाज आल्सो वेयरिंग दिस जैसे तावीज काइंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स ही वाज वेयरिंग हिज मेन रिमूव्ड हिज हेड एंड एवरी जॉइंट ऑफ हिज बॉडी After they finished, they reassembled the remains in a wooden box with padding filled with layer of sand to conceal the damage. It was his resting place. After taking out the gold, what he did was a bed of sand bichaya and kept the body over it. In the past few decades, archaeology has changed as it now focuses on the details of life and the mysteries of death. Earlier, it was about focusing on the treasure. In 1968, an anatomy professor x-rayed King Tut's mummy and he revealed that the front ribs and the breastbone were missing. Now, these are the three coffins of King Tut. Up 1922 mein to uski mummy mili. 1968 mein one professor x-rayed the mummy, King Tut's mummy, and he found that front limbs or breastbone were missing. So, us time pe probably Egyptians knew, us time pe plastic surgery unko pata thi ki what they did was probably these are the parts which probably get spoiled in so much time. So they had removed those parts before finally mummifying it. Now with the advancement of technology, CT scan or computer tomography can give a virtual image of the whole body. With the help of the technology, King Tut's body would be scanned to find the answers to two questions. The reason why it was being scanned, how he died and how old was he at the time of his death. His death was a shock to the royals also, as he was the last person of his family and his funeral indicated the end of his dynasty, which had ruled Egypt for centuries. However, what happened after his death is still not. Now, Tut's father or grandfather, Amenhotep III, was a very powerful pharaoh who ruled over the period of 40 years. ये सबसे उसके ग्रैंडफादर थे 40 इयर्स के लिए ही रूल्ड. हिज सन अमेनहोटेप IV सक्सीडेड हिम एंड बिगन द स्ट्रेंजेस्ट पीरियड इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इजिप्ट. उसके बाद में कौन हु बिकेम द सक्सेसर अमेनहोटेप IV उसके फादर. नाउ उस टाइम पे ये दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड. सब लोग ग्रैंडफादर के टाइम पे दे यूज्ड टू प्रे अ गॉड कॉल्ड विंड गॉड वायु देवता लाइक आमुन, उसकी प्रेस करते थे. और जो उसका फादर था दैट इज अमेनहोटेप IV, ही स्टार्टेड वर्शिपिंग एटन. एटन वॉज द सन गॉड. ही प्रमोटेड द वर्शिप ऑफ एटन द सन डिस्क. ही चेंज हिज नेम फ्रॉम अमेनहोटेप IV टू अखनेटन, मीनिंग द सर्वेंट ऑफ एटन, एंड ही नेम्ड हिज सन एज तुतनखामन. तो उसने क्या किया, उसने कहा सिंस आई एम द वर्शिपर ऑफ एटन सन, सो उसने अपना नाम चेंज कर लिया फ्रॉम अमेनहोटेप टू अखनेटन, एंड he named his son as Tutankhaten. He also shifted the religious capital from Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten called Amarna. Aur usne apni capital bhi shift kari new to Amarna. Further he attacked Amun the wind god, smashed his images and closed his temples. Aur sare jo temples the unke sare tod diye, aur sare all the temples were destroyed, his images were destroyed, his idols were destroyed. That is why he was called as a mad pharaoh. Sab log bolte the pagal king hai, and at that point of time Egypt did not survive at all. Bahut zyada it was not at its power. After his death another mysterious ruler Samankhare succeeded him and died soon. Because King Tut was very young at that point of time, so thode time ke liye ek minister Samankhare bana tha. Uske baad mein King Tut was made the ruler. Next King Tut sat on the throne and ruled for 9 years. Firstly, he changed his name from Tutankhaten to Tutankhamun and worshipped God Amun like his ancestors and restored the lost glory of Egypt. Fifth, the moment he became the king, usne apna naam change kiya from Tutankhaten to Tutankhamun because he worshipped Lord Amun all over again and restored his temples of Lord Amun and everything, all the lost glory of Egypt was restored. The CT scan machine scanned the body by creating 1700 digital x-rays in the cross section. The resulting image was very strange. A team of radiology, forensics and anatomy experts started examining the secrets of the grave that had been protected for a long time. During the night, workmen climbed up the ramp and the flight of stairs to carry the body from the tomb to a trailer where the scanner was kept. After 20 minutes, two men ran to his office nearby to bring two fans. The scanner was not working as the sand had entered the fan. Everyone thought that it was because of the pharaoh's curse because they had removed his body from the grave, and so they were annoyed. Now what happens? Basically, they were very scared that probably pharaoh's curse hamar ko na lag jaye. So what they happens? Now CT scan machine ko, if you are using that, मशीन बहुत गर्म हो जाएगी, तो उसके लिए उन्होंने एक ट्रेलर बिछाया हुआ था. ट्रेलर वो क्या होता है जिसमें where you keep lot of trucks, जिसमें लेके जाते हैं कार्स वगैरह लेके जाते हैं. सो दे हैड केप्ट इट इन द ट्रेलर, और ट्रेलर में दे हैड पुट इन टू फैंस. अब एसी तो लग नहीं सकता, सो दे हैड पुट इन टू फैंस और उस फैन से चला रखे थे ताकि द मशीन डज नॉट गेट हॉट. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड, वन फैन स्टॉप्ड. क्यों घुल गया? क्योंकि सैंड में फैन चल रहा है, तो सैंड गॉट स्टक इन टू द फैन एंड स्टॉप. Now what happened, suddenly another fan was brought in and finally everybody thought that it is a pharaoh's curse. Now everybody was very scared. Jaise maine pehle bataya tha that there were clouds in the sky. Egypt jaisi jagah mein clouds wagera hona, it was a big thing at that point time. Unko lag raha tha it is the pharaoh is getting annoyed aur wo curse hamare ko lag jayegi. A second fan was brought. Once the fans worked, the procedure was finished. Then technicians returned the body to the pallbearers. Pallbearers kaun hote hain? Jo अर्थी उठाते हैं. वो कैरीड हिम ब्रैक टू हिज टूम. इन लेस देन 3 आवर्स ही वॉज रेस्टिंग एट द सेम प्लेस विद अ प्रीस्ट हैड लेड हिम मेनी ईयर्स अगो. फाइनली आफ्टर सीटी स्कैन ही वॉज केप्ट इन दैट सेम टूम विद हिज रेस्ट. Now these are the digital X-rays of Tut. Can you imagine 3300 years ago this guy had died and still we could see all the bones of his body. In the trailer, the technician showed a beautiful image of Tut on a computer screen. He showed the gray head which was scattered in pixels and he spun it around. Next, the vertebrae, hand, rib cage, transection of the skull was shown. As the work was done, the pressure was finally off from the shoulders of Zahi Hawass. So finally, they had received the images. So Zahi Hawass was relieved. Everything has taken place and there is no problem now. While sitting in his chair, he smiled and said that he was relieved that nothing went wrong. He had not slept the previous night. And now, as the work was done, he could go and sleep. By the time they left the trailer, the wind had stopped just above the tomb. The Orion constellation stone, the night sky, watching over the boy, the king. Now what happens? Finally, the body was rested in its tomb. Or aaj bhi wo body is under the Orion constellation. You must have read about constellations in science. So Orion the hunter, uska ek god hota hai, God Osiris. Osiris is the guardian of death. So under the guardian of death, uske niche aaj bhi King Tut ki tomb is resting. I hope you understand the chapter. Happy learning. Please like, share, subscribe. Thank you.